The anatomy of a successful business. What if we give a human structure to a business, and if we had to describe all the parts, what would that be? These are the 12 essential elements for a business to really, really skyrocket to the next level. Let's dive in. Hi, this is James Vineet, author, coach, and a good friend who wants to see your business grow exponentially yet systematically. So these are the 12 elements. Number one, you know, people say manage from your left, lead from your right. So your business needs to use both the left and right brains. But when you use the right brain, that's when you start leading the business. That's when you start strategizing, because your right brain is very, very creative. Right? So left brain is more of logical, right brain is super creative. So when you apply the right brain stuff, you know, you kind of envision bigger things, things that are totally unconventional. Will this really happen? Because every big idea or a dream was once a crazy concept. Sometimes you need to have that urge in business to dream the thing that nobody ever dreamt of, right? So number one is lead people, leadership, strategizing the future. And number two is, again, the left brain, manage or measure the past. The different way to manage, I would say, is start measuring. Because that's what even Peter Drucker says, what gets measured gets managed. You want to manage something, start measuring it. You know, I love saying these examples. You visit somebody to get an advice to save time or even to reduce weight. Obviously, they'll give you wonderful, wonderful advices. But one of the common advices I would say is they'll give you a piece of pen and paper and they'll ask you to audit, basically log in whatever you're doing the whole day. Just log all those tasks. And out of all those works, what are essential, what are non-essential for the time tracking. And if it's health or weight loss, that would be food tracking, intake tracking. Every 1 hour, just write whatever you're taking inside. As you write itself, you'll kind of come to know that, oh my God, I'm doing so many unwanted work. I'm having excess intake. Why am I even eating all these things? That's why I tell you, dear friends, what gets measured gets managed. When you want to manage something, start measuring that. So what do you need to manage in your business? Be it performance, be it profit, be it cost, how many people are coming to your store, how many people are buying from you, how many quotations given, how many quotations are converting, how many people visited your website, the bounce rate, every single thing. Start measuring all those minute things in your business. That's when you'll start really managing things like a pro. Okay, 3, 4, 5, and 6 is all over here. 3 is observe, R&D. Use those 2 years of your business to really observe what's happening, what people are telling you, the pain points of your customers, the feedback from the customers, why customers are preferring you over the competitors, all of that. Invest a lot of money also into R&D so that you know the future products or services that you need to launch, and that will give you great results as well. And 4 is vision casting. Have a vision and get everybody to see that vision. That's very, very important. Many companies have great vision, but they don't vision cast it. What is vision casting? Is giving your employees also a good feel of how would it be when that vision comes true. 25 years later, 10 years later, when our company reaches to that level, if I'm also an employee of this company, where would my growth in this firm be? That's very, very important. 5 is marketing. You know, speak out loud. Tell to the whole world that you exist. Make some noise with your marketing out there. Obviously, it's essential, because if you look at marketing, there's a concept called AIDA, A-I-D-A. Awareness, interest, desire, and action. The first part is awareness. People in your segment, or, you know, the customers who are in your target segment, should know that you exist in the first place. Suppose you have a store and there are about 3.5 lakh people around you living there, and maybe about 45 to 55,000 people could become your customers. The first step is to reach out and let them know that you as a business exist. Right? And 6 is discerning, related to the nose. Smell what's wrong, smell what's cooking. When there is a call to your office, you need to have that discernment to know whether this call is actually made by a customer or a prospect, genuine prospect, or some competitor trying to get our quotation or rates outside. Discernment. See what's cooking. Okay, so you need to know whether, you know, who are your profitable customers, who are your good customers, who are your loyal customers, your good employees. Start recognizing. You need to be able to differentiate, you know, the good soul out of all this crowd that is there in the market, right? And number seven is love for people. People in your company needs to feel loved. Yes, performance is important, but when they don't come to office, you ask them why you have not come. But somebody in your company needs to go and talk to them. Hey, why is your face dull? What's happening? You know, you don't look like normal. Is there any problem? Is there something that I can assist you with? Communicate the love language for your employees. Number eight is strong at execution. Some companies are very poor with execution. You've got great vision, great ideas, but that idea is even copied by a competitor and they are executing it better than us. You need to be strong at execution. Otherwise, ideas will just be ideas. It'll be scribbling on a paper. That's it. Just a plan on a paper. Be great at execution. And number nine is high impact. Whatever you do, the impact should be really strong. The products that you sell, the services that you offer in the lives of the customer and the lives of your employees. Before buying your product or before joining your company and after buying your product, after joining your company, there should be a transformation. Don't have a transactional relationship. Transaction is like, I gave you money, you gave me the product. You give me salary, I work for you. Transformation is, you know, something beyond that. Make an impact by changing the way people live, right? Highly essential. Number 10 is digest changes. You know, I'd like to talk about this health concept where people say it's good to chew the food and eat. But many times I find that people, you know, they don't chew much, right? They just swallow it up. Experts say your stomach shouldn't know what you ate. But today, if you take a picture or a scan, you'll see that the food is just there in the stomach, like how it was in the plate. That's not a good way to eat, by the way. But what I'm trying to tell you is that whatever you eat, your stomach is somehow digesting it and pushing it outside, right? Your business needs to become a robust business like that. Anything that comes in a way, digest that. Digest all the changes. It could be tax changes, government changes, COVID, whatnot. Being able to digest those changes and adapting to the changes. See, people say after COVID, you know, this business changed, that business changed. If you look at it deep inside, no business has really changed. The customers are there, the business is still there. Just the way how we communicate with them, how we offer or deliver the product or service has changed. Therefore, the business is still there. People who have adapted to the new change, people who have digested the changes and adapted to the new mode of working, they are still really growing their business. So digest the changes. Number 11 is steady pace. Consistency is very important. I know all entrepreneurs are committed, but the question here is, are we consistent? Consistency is being able to replicate the same thing over and over and over again with the same energy, love and passion and care and commitment. Are we really doing that? It's like going to gym. There are people who go to gym continuously every single day, and in a not one day, 2 day, they'll see result. In a span of 3-4 months, they'll see the change, they'll see the transformation. But what some people do is they don't go 3-4 days or 5 days, then 1 or 2 days they go, they overwork out, and then they again relax. That's not how it works. Even look at some of our social media accounts. If you're not even posting at least 15 posts in a whole month, what are we doing out there on social media? We're only consuming content, not creating content out there as a business entity. Consistency matters, my dear friends. Be it timely delivery, being sending quotations on time, be it, you know, punctuality with customer services, all of that, consistency is the key. And last but not the least, 12 is deeply rooted. Business could be something that you started or your forefathers started, but you know, they all started with a vision, with a value system, with ethics in mind, deeply rooted to those ethics. This is how I will operate. You know, we will treat customers this way, and we are born to do that. You know, just sticking to your own core values and being deeply rooted is very, very essential. Otherwise, it'll be like wavering. Should I change this business? Should I add that particular product line? This, that? No. This is my core product. Maybe you can add other allied products, but this is my core product and this is my vision and this is the value proposition that I'll be adding to the customer, and these are the rules that we have as a policy for the business, and we'll stick on to this. So in this video, what I want you to do is don't just be, you know, a listener or a learner, but go ahead and put that in the comment section below. What elements do you think you need to improve in your business? Out of these 12 elements that we talked about, what are the 2 or 3 or 4 things that your business needs to develop? You really love this content? You know what? This is a small snippet from the 5-day holistic business growth program. In fact, it's a 5-day program with a 100 days action plan purely for entrepreneurs. And if you want to know more about that program, you can actually click the link below and, you know, check out the details. I would really be happy to interact with you in our 5-day holistic business growth program as well. Not to miss, if you have not subscribed to our channel or not following our podcast or not following our pages, I would highly recommend you to do that right now, because every single week I'll come back and meet you with some amazing content like this. Till then, this is James Vineet signing off.